So you level your bed by telling the printer to go to home, and then you get out your paper, and you stick it underneath, and you think a paper's thickness is how far the bed needs to be below the nozzle, right? Well, I'm afraid you're wrong. I know this has been done by other creators in the past, but I wanted to make a simple short video on this and only this so that I can explain it as clearly as possible with no fluff, and you can watch it, and you can share it with your friends, and we can all start understanding exactly how bed leveling works. Let's start by drawing stuff. Here is a representation of 3D printing layer by layer. The hot end has the nozzle on the end, and the nozzle spits out a predetermined amount of molten filament based on the layer height and line width that you have specified. At the end of every layer, it raises the hot end and thus the nozzle by exactly the line height, and I can prove that in a moment, and then it repeats the process. The slicer that you're using programs the extrusion rate to extrude enough filament, in the very basic sense, to fill a rectangle which is around the height of your layer height setting and around the width of your line width setting. If you want to know more about that, I have an accompanying video that will be released around the same time as this, which has some interesting revelations on that, to say the least, but let's not get distracted here. The first layer is no different to any other layer, and I can prove that too. The first layer extrudes exactly the same amount as every other layer. So we can see on this end-on diagram how that would play out. Now, the reason you're leveling wrong is because the first layer is just a normal layer. It is no higher and no more material is extruded than the second layer or any other layer. So why would you have the print bed anywhere else but literally zero with respect to where the printer thinks Z equals zero is? If you home the printer and then use a piece of paper or card or whatever to space the bed, what is it you're getting? You're getting this. And because I like to back up my assertions with evidence, here is some G-code generated by Cura for a simple cuboid. You'll get the same answer from Prusa Slicer if you generate it there too. If you see the code here for a layer height of 0.2mm, the first thing the slicer has told the printer to do after the start code and the purge line is to move up to Z equals 0.2mm, and from then on you can see that there are no more Z move commands. The whole layer is being extruded with the nozzle at exactly one layer height. Yes, I know, it's calculated on base 0, so layer 1 is actually called layer 0, and the second layer is layer 1, but don't let that confuse things. But you can see here the Z0.4 command. And then layer 3, which is called layer 2 here, you can see the Z0.6. It's pretty obvious when you think about it, really, isn't it? But the point is that there's no mystery offsets here. When you say you want a 0.2 layer height, you get a 0.2 layer height right from the start. So that is exactly how you should calibrate your print bed. Unless you're doing something weird, you should have it so that the surface of the bed sits at exactly Z equals zero. It is literally that simple. So what do you need to do to achieve this? Well, you have a couple of options, but if you want to use a known thickness to calibrate the bed, then you need to home the printer, as usual. Then you need to go into the controls and you need to raise the printer by the thickness of your known material. And then, this is actually important too, you need to actually use your printer's controls to navigate the head across the bed. If you do it by hand, then you probably have the servos turned off, and this will allow the Z-axis to sag while you're moving it, and that will mean that the distance may not be actually the same across the entire bed. A second option is to do it by eye, and this is a method I tend to use more often. First home the printer, then turn off the motors or leave them on, whatever. Calibrate with paper, as you normally would. And it's important to note that the reason I do use paper is just to stop the nozzle from scratching the bed while I'm doing this. It also helps to heat up your nozzle so that you can wipe any filament off that happens to still be on the bottom. And once you finish that, then all you need to do is about a quarter turn on each wheel on each corner, up to compensate for the paper. This is not super accurate, in fact it's not usually that close at all, but that's why you then have to manually level on the fly when you start printing. I've put a card in the corner for how to get hold of this template and how to use it, but if your part isn't super critical, then you can get away with just creating a brim wide enough that you can finish the leveling on the fly before the part actually starts properly printing. Now you could use a Z offset in the firmware or the start code when you're manually leveling, but I don't really like that option, so I won't cover it in this video. If you're doing that, then you probably already know what you're doing anyway, so you don't need me to tell you. There is a final option, which is to install auto bed leveling of some kind, but that is a discussion for another time, definitely. Now, as to whether a normal amount of squish is enough for the first layer, well, that is also a discussion for another time, and it's coming up a little bit in the next video. But I think that now you hopefully understand how this process works, you can make a more informed decision on how you want to do that. If you like this kind of thing, then this is exactly my kind of thing, so please subscribe and I will see you in the next one. Thank you for watching.